to our lesson for today. So we've just talked about how Amos went all the way from Judah to Israel so that he can give the message of God to the people of Israel. But how the people of Israel refused to listen to the message, even though he told them God wants fairness and kindness and justice, they refused to listen and they sent him away. So after Amos had left, a little while later, God sent another prophet to speak to the people of Israel and to give them his message. This prophet was from Israel itself, and his name was Prophet Hosea.
So Hosea was a prophet that lived in Israel, and he was married to a very pretty girl that he loved so much. Her name was Gomer. Amos and Gomer had their first child, and it was a
baby boy. And they were so happy, and Amos was so happy that they had a child. But Gomer did not want to sit in the house and take care of the baby boy. What she wanted to do was go out to the town
and party and have fun
and do whatever she wanted, but not take care of her children. And then when they had their second child, a little girl, Hosea thought that Gomer would change,
not but that they had the second child, but still
she didn't. She still went out and do whatever she wanted to do. And then when after they had their third child, Gomer went out one day and she never came back.
Now this made Prophet Hosea very, very sad, because he really loved
Gomer so much.
So when she was sad that Gomer was not there, that she had left,
and he was heartbroken.
He didn't know how to take care of three kids without Gomer. I mean,
and he was lonely, and she had left him all alone, and he was feeling so sad miserable and heartbroken. And then God spoke to Hosea and said, Hosea, I know exactly what you feel. I love the people of Israel so much. But just like Gomer, they have gone away and left me and decided to worship Baal. And the same way that you feel sad and miserable,
it's the same way I feel. So sad and so hard. So God told Hosea that I really understand your heart and everything that you're going through.
And then Hosea started to understand how much the people of Israel and how much their disobedience
had hurt God so much.
But God told him, Do not stop loving your wife. Do not stop loving her. Don't give up on her.
Go and find her and win her back
and bring her home.
Now that is something that the men in Israel never know to do.
If your wife went,
you were not supposed to go for her. But now this time around, God told Prophet Hosea, you have to go and find your wife. So Hosea decided that he was going to find someone to take care of the three children as he went out to look for his wife, and that is what he did. So he went round and looked for Gomer everywhere. He tried to find her everywhere, and then finally he found her at the house of
a man
that was a rich man who had bought Gomer and kept her in her house, in his house as a slave.
So Gomer was now a slave, and she was miserable, and she was so sad, and she was so tired. Now Hosea found her, and even though she had hurt him, and even though she had betrayed him, and even though she had left him with their three children, he gave all the money he had, everything he had, he took it and he gave it to that man so that he can get Gomer back. So he got Gomer back. And from then on, Hosea preached the message of God differently. He told the people of Israel, God loves you. He loves you so much, and it has hurt him so bad that you have decided to go and worship Baal. Come back to him. He is waiting for you. He wants to love you and he wants to forgive you. He does not want to punish you. But if you keep worshiping Baal and if you keep refusing to come back to God, yeah, then you will bring suffering to all of Israel. Yes. Come back and ask and tell God you are sorry.
Just he come and ask for forgiveness. God is waiting and He's waiting to forgive you
and He's waiting to love you and to take you back. And yes, that is the message Hosea gave to the people all over Israel.
Yes.
So kids, what we learn from this is God loves us so much.
Yes.
The same way Hosea loved Gomer, that no matter what she did, when she left him, when he went to find her, when she had betrayed him, no matter what she did,
he still wanted her back because
he loved her so much.
Yes.
And the same way God loves us like that and so much more. So even when we do anything wrong or anything bad,
yes,
we should always go back to God because He loves us so much that He's willing to take us back no matter what we do.
Yes. So we're going to stand up and sing our song. So let's all stand up.
Okay, kids, we've just talked about how God loves us so much, and that He continues to love us no matter what we do. Even when we make a mistake or get into trouble, we should always come back to God because He's waiting to forgive us and to love us.
Yes.
So now we're gonna sing a song about how wonderful God's love is. So everyone stand up and help us sing this song.
God's love is very, very wonderful. God's love is very, very wonderful. God's love is very, very wonderful. So wonderful love. God's love is very, very wonderful. God's love is very, very wonderful. God's love is very, very wonderful. So wonderful love. So
from talking about how God loves us so much, and how when we disobey Him, it hurts Him so much, and He misses us and He wants us back. And we've also learned that when you come back to God, He doesn't want to punish you, He wants to forgive you, and He wants to love you. So to remember this, we are going to make a necklace, and what we're going to put on our necklace is a heart. And this heart is going to remind us that the love of God is so big and so wonderful and so great, and that we can always go back to God no matter what, because He always wants us to come back. So what we have here is we have a manila paper that we cut into the shape of a heart. So we drew a heart and we cut it out. So now we're going to color it, and then we're going to write our message on it, and then we're going to put a ribbon through it so we can wear it and we can hang it around us all the time, so we can remember never to forget God's love and to always go back to God's love. Okay, so now that I have my heart colored, next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to write down the message that was given by Hosea. So Hosea said, God loves you so much. Let me say, always go back to God.
So we find the story of Hosea in the book of Hosea.
Okay, so now we have our message written down. Now we need to be able to wear our message so that it is with us wherever we go and we can have it around us all the time. So take your paper punch and make a hole on one side of your heart and then make a hole on the other side of your heart. And then I want you to take a ribbon and put the ribbon through and then tie a knot. Make sure it's nice and tight, and then do the same thing on the other side of your heart. So now that we have our heart, now we need to wear it. So put on the necklace and wear the heart. So now we have a heart that says God loves you so much. Always go back to God. And our story is found in the book of Hosea. So whenever we see this heart necklace, we will always remember that God loves us so much, even when we make mistakes, and that we should always, always, always go back to God.
Yes. So this is our love necklace that reminds us of God's love, that even when you make a mistake, God is always ready to accept you back because He loves you so much. So that's our lesson today, and that's our craft today. Until next time,
bye!